Hey guys, what is going on? Welcome back to another video here on the channel. Now in today's video, we're going to be looking at the KV value and what its role in relationship is with the total amount of potential torque output that we can get from a motor. Now the way that we're going to go ahead and do this is we're going to first run through a bunch of specifications that we're quite familiar with, and then we're going to go and take a look at a bunch of specifications right off of a motor manufacturer's data sheet and perform the calculations to see what kind of torque output that we get. And then lastly, what we'll do is we'll show you a snippet of information directly from a motor manufacturer's website. So let's not waste any time and jump right into today's video. So I have two different motors here in front of me, and I want to make a very good point. So the point that I want to make is that we are not going to be comparing two motors here of a different size can. You can obviously see that one motor here is a lot larger than the other motor. We know that this larger motor here is going to be able to provide a lot more power and a lot more torque, and maybe not at a similar RPM. It might have a lower RPM, but overall you're going to get more power and torque out of this motor. What we're gonna do within the video and everything that we talk about is we're gonna only compare motors of a similar diameter and exact same length. So exact same diameter, exact same length, and that's it. It's the motor that exists within the same classification from the manufacturer that you're trying to compare against. And this is going to come based off of different winds that are available. This is where you see different KVs. When you change the wind, you get a different KV value. And this leads us right into our definitions that we're gonna have here for the parameters that we'll see. KV value, you've seen this tons all over the place. It simply just represents the amount of RPM that you get out of the motor for every volt that you apply. When we talk about current, we're gonna see current being playing a significant role here in today's video. The current is typically measured in amps within our power systems. We know that as you increase the load, you should expect more current coming out from that motor or power system. Another value that we're going to look at, and this is the key to this video, is the KT value. The KT value is simply calculated based off of the KV value when you take its inverse value, where the KT value is going to be the amount of torque output that you get out of a motor for every amp that you put into the motor. That is key and a big part of today's video. And the last value that we're looking at today is going to be the amount of torque output that we get out of the motor. Torque is simply a measurement of the amount of force that we can produce at a specific distance. Now let's head over to the whiteboard and go through a bunch of specific specifications right from a motor manufacturer's specification sheet. All right, here we are. We're over at the whiteboard. We're going to go through a bunch of specifications that come directly off of a motor manufacturer's spec sheet. We're going to go through and look at all these values and then make a couple calculations to determine the actual potential torque that we can get out from the motors, all with different types of winds. Now, the thing to keep in mind is that all these different motors have the same diameter and same length of can. They all come from the same manufacturer as well. The only thing that changes is the wind that has been selected. So let's go ahead and take a look at what we've done. So the first two parameters, these come directly off the specification sheet. And as you'll notice here, as you drop in KV value, you will also drop in the maximum current that that motor could potentially deliver. Here we start off at 132 amps that you can pull from this 3960 KV motor. However, if you drop to the 660 KV motor, you're only going to be able to pull a maximum of 22 amps. That is a huge significant difference. Now we move over to the third column here on our chart. We have the KT value. This is our torque constant that we just talked about not too long ago. The way that you can go and calculate the torque constant is by taking 1 divided by that 3960. If you want to go and do this, you have to make sure that instead of RPM per volt, you'd convert this into radians per second per volt. There's two ways to do that. You can simply multiply 3960 by 2 pi over 60, or you can do what I prefer, is just go in, find an area of the internet that has a calculator already there, so you can just plug the numbers in, hit the enter button, and it spits it out for you. Either way, you're gonna get the same result. You go ahead and do that. What I've also done to my numbers is I've knocked them down by 1,000. So I'm actually representing the torque per amp by millinewton meters per amp. And the way that I do that is just by multiplying the value that you get by 1,000, and you'll get this value here as output. Then the last thing that we do here is we take the amount of KT that we have, we multiply that by the maximum current, and we're gonna get the specification of torque. So here you can see as you go down and you decrease the amount of potential for the maximum current that you can push through a specific motor, you're also increasing the KT value of your motor. So if you say as you decrease the KV value of a motor, you will actually increase the KT value of a motor, this would be correct. However, it would not be correct to say that you get a potential torque output that is higher by going to these lower KV motors. As you can see, the torque potential of all these motors from this specification sheet on a high quality motor manufacturer is around the 318 mark. All these motors have the exact same value when you just simply multiply the current by the KT value in order to determine what kind of torque output you're going to get. So really, if you have that 3960 kV motor and you want to get more torque output, so you say, hey, I'm gonna drop all the way down to the 660 kV motor. Well, the big problem here is that you just had the potential to deliver 132 amps to that motor and it would handle it no problem, but now you only have a maximum of 22 amps that you can deliver to this small kV motor in the same size classification of that 3960 kV motor. You would be correct in saying that that motor is going to give you a much higher amount of torque potential per amp. However, because the amps are so low, you are going to get the exact same torque output from that motor as a potential versus our 3960 kV motor here at 318. It's quite interesting to see this all written out like that and come to the exact same conclusion of torque output for all our different motors. Now, if you were to actually look at the power potential that the motor manufacturer specifies this at, you're gonna see that value consistent for all the motors. I can't remember what it is for this specific motor. Let's say it's 2000 watts. Every one of these motors is going to be able to deliver 2000 watts. And the RPM maximum of the motor is going to be the same also for every single one of these motors. If it's 60,000, which it probably is for this motor, all of these motors are going to be able to deliver that same 60,000 RPM. So what you're seeing here essentially is that all the wattages are the same, all the torques are the same, and all the RPMs are the same for all of these motors when you're talking about the maximum potential for these here. Definitely something quite interesting when you lay it all out on the board like we've done here. Now, the last thing that I wanted to do is go through a snippet of information that comes directly off of a motor manufacturer's website. Don't just take this from me. Take a look at what the motor manufacturer here is saying. Essentially, what the motor manufacturer is saying here is that if you half the KV of a motor, you are essentially going to get half the amount of power output out of that motor. The reason why they say this is true is because all the different winds of motors that you can purchase within the same classification is going to deliver the exact same amount of torque output. They go on to state exactly why this is, and I can put it in a different way. If you take a look at a specific motor, it is of a certain size, obviously, right? And what is important about this is that the magnets, if you were to compare it to another identical motor, are the same. And the other thing inside of it that is the same is the total amount of copper that make up the windings. Even though the windings are changing, the total amount of copper that you use in the motor is going to be identical. If you go and use more windings, you have to decrease the diameter of the winding in order to fit the same amount of copper into the motor. If you use the same amount of copper and the same magnets, you are going to get the same amount of torque output no matter how the winding changes within a specific motor. Very much like most of the videos here on my channel, I like to provide some form of conclusion at the end of the video. So let's go ahead and do that here as well. I believe that the big takeaway for this video is if you're trying to get more torque output for your power system and you're looking at the difference in kV, if you are choosing a motor that has the same exact dimensions, you're just changing the winding, you are not going to get the potential to deliver more torque output. It is going to be the same. However, what you are actually going to do, especially if you run it on the same voltage, is you're going to significantly hurt the performance of your setup. You're not going to get the same amount of power output because you're dropping the overall RPM that you have available. If you want to get a higher amount of torque output from your motor, you can't just look at the same exact size. What you have to do is look at the size up. Now, this is not the size up, but you get my point. Going to a larger motor is going to be able to give you more power potential from this motor, as well as more torque potential from the motor. Well, guys, that pretty well sums it up for this video. Like the video if you do. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button so that I can see you in that next video. Thanks a lot for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.